it's a blessing to be here today. Woke up excited about the moment and excited about being a Tiger and just excited about our future and the foundation that we're laying. It's a process. It's trying to get everybody to buy in and to being successful on the court and off the court. But so far, it's been a great process. And today, I'm blessed to have, you know, one of our guards, Ivy Smith, and another one of our guards, Shemay Thomas, by my side. And I expect these two guys to lead us through a lot of the battles this year. So that's where we are right now.
We're going to open the floor for any questions.
Coach, you take over Gremlin in unique time, coming off one of the best seasons in program history. How do you keep Gremlin on the uproar?
Well, the goal is just keep building talent. You know, keep building guys and keep instilling good values and bringing in more talent. That's just always the case. You know, if you want to be good, it takes talent, it takes structure, it takes discipline. It's not a secret to the recipe. It's just the way it goes.
Coach, speaking of new guys, you have a lot of new faces. Let's talk a little bit about those guys.
We end up coming in late. We had a few guys transfer. In the process of having a few guys transfer, we had to get out and try to replace some guys. So this year was our first year of being able to recruit some junior college kids. So we went out and tried to get some of the best kids we possibly could get. We got a 6'8 guy that's very athletic, that can play inside, play outside. XL Empoyo, we expect him to do a lot of big things this year. Great touch from the perimeter. Then we got a few other guys that transferred in. Trayvon Bunch, who is one of the JUCO top 20 kids in the country. So we're going to try to find ways to get good, so be good and go from there.
Coach, you know, I know we've talked about it, but the preseason rankings for the SWAC came out. Grambling was ranked 7th. Talk about the ranking, and, you know, I know it's not where you start, but how you finish.
Well, you know, honestly, I don't really look at a lot of the preseason stuff. You know, it's, you know, right now you can rank us 351st. That's fine, too. It's about where you finish at the end of the day. So we're going to work our butts off night in, night out. We're going to trust the process, and we're going to move forward, and we're going to keep building. That's just our reality of it. And, you know, with the preseason rankings, you know, it's cool to be ranked 7th. You know, like I tell our guys, that's fine. But it's about what you're going to go out there and what you're going to leave on that court and how people are going to remember you at the end of the season.
For not only you, Dante, but the players as well, just talk a little bit about what you guys have seen in terms of chemistry so far, practice with the guys on this year's team.
This year we have great chemistry as far as from the new people that came in to the old people we have today. It's been a pretty great practice for the last 3 weeks that we had, even from the summer. Everyone's well connected. We all talk on and off the court. We have a great chemistry. As far as just practice off the court, everybody's always together, always talking. We always find a way to just come together, come to the gym late nights, get extra work in. So, I mean, we all work hard to get to a point where we're trying to win a championship this year. Our mindset is just win. We don't want to just come in and just have a great game. We want to come in and win, and we plan on having the championship swag this year.
Well, like Ivy just said, the chemistry is there. The talent is there. We just got to be more disciplined. You know, we're young right now, a lot of new faces and stuff like that. But we got a good team, and I think we can win big. Like, not just win, but win big. And a lot of people really don't understand that until they come in and, like, watch us practice and stuff like that. So at the end of the day, we still got to play. So we're going to see how it turns out.
You know, that's our main thing. You know, one of the things, it's funny because I get people that say, when I see your whole coaching staff together, whenever I see you, I see your whole coaching staff. It's about chemistry. You know, it's about, you know, if the players see that the coaches are together, it reflects that the players should be together. And it's just the little things that makes a difference in a program and a culture of being successful. And, you know, that's why I challenged them on our first meeting. Get to know the new guys. Got to get to know the new guys, you know. And once you get to know the new guys, then they'll become part of the family. And, you know, one of our biggest things we say is, 1, 2, 3, GSU, 4, 5, 6, family. You got to believe that. Everybody got to believe that we family, you know, and everybody got to look out for one another. Everybody got to take care of one another, and everybody got to hold each other accountable. You know, we talk a lot about accountability. We talk a lot about discipline. We talk a lot about being a great teammate, because it's bigger than basketball. Basketball is only going to take you so far, but it's the other parts of life that basketball shows up in. So, you know, like right now we're young, we're still in early phases of trying to learn. And, you know, we got guys that came from different programs. Well, coach, we did it this way. No, we're not doing it that way no more. We're doing it this way. Like, this is the way it's going to be done. So it's just a process of trying to instill, you know, our structure, our discipline, our organization, how we go about things on a day-to-day. But, you know, it's great having leaders, you know, like guys like Shermaine, who can come in, who can be a little vocal, who can say, hey, coach, man, we need to do this. Hey, coach, what about this? And what about that? Because for me, I'm big on, you know, having my guys talk to me. I'm not one of those guys who's just, man, no, you don't get to say nothing. No, Shermaine, you're senior. Talk to me, brother. Ivy, you're the point guard. Talk to me. You got to tell me what's going on. And, you know, even after practice, you know, sometime I'll call Shermaine and be like, hey, man, kind of a tough practice. I kind of got on such and such, man. Talk to him. Keep his head up, man. You know, we're going to need him throughout the year. But, you know, it's my job sometime to get on some guys, and that's just the reality of it. And then there's times where I got to build guys up. You know, it's just the reality. This is part of coaching. You know, it is what it is. And sometime with our chemistry, man, sometimes I think we too much of friends. I'm like, man, so, like, man, you just gotta let him have an open jump shot? What are you doing? Like, what's going on? Oh, coach, it's nah, young fella. We're trying to build great habits. So, you know, it's good to have these guys, you know, really bonding and getting to be together and liking each other on and off the court. I'd have been with some teams that didn't like each other on and off the court. So it's great when they do like each other on and off the court. And I feel like it's accelerating our process. It's accelerating us to move a little faster than normally because guys actually do want to share the ball with each other. And sometimes, like I tell our guys, sometimes he didn't miss you on purpose. He was just looking to score. It's not personal. He just, yeah, we got to talk about it and we got to fix it.
Ivy, you have 1 year under your belt. Just speak a little bit about that leadership role, being a point guard of this basketball team.
Well, the leadership role is going to become very hard. More harder for me this year. Not harder, but I want to say I have to be better than I was last year because I was behind a senior. He had more experience than me, so last year it really showed me a lot what I need to do, how to become a better leader on and off the court, and I just got to be progressive, listen to my coach, whatever he needs me to do, that's what I need to do. If I need to be more vocal, tell my players where they need to be, know plays from plays, pretty much just be his tool on the court and not let everybody be on the downfall when things go bad.
Coach, you're losing, you aren't here, but from last year's team, 44 points per game lost.
Saying, no, let's go 44.
talk about the process of trying to fill those holes.
You know, when you, I guess, kind of losing two seniors that was major, and we had a guy transfer out because of, you know, our postseason ban or whatnot, you're losing a lot. You know, you're losing a lot. But the good thing is that we brought in some talented guys. Now it's just about trying to build chemistry and understanding how to play together. You know, and that's playing together, you know, takes care of everything. You know, for me, in my past teams, I haven't had one guy or two guys be focal points. It's been four, five, six guys that can actually score and the ball moves and we play together and we make the extra pass and we believe that if I call it the hockey assist, that if I pass to him and he passed to him and it was the correct pass, we get a score out of it. So we just got to believe in the same things that got us to this point.
Coach,
yes,
what do you believe will make this team X factor?
Well, we have depth. We have some height. I think really the main thing is just going to be our guard play. You know, we're young. We're young. Ivy is going to be his first full-time role in his first 3 years. So I don't expect him to be just, you know, come out the door and do all. He's just amazing. It'll be great if he is. You know, don't get me wrong. It'll be great if he is. But at the end of the day, he has to grow. And we believe in him growing. And then even like with Shemaine, it's his first time really being put in a scoring role. You know, and it's like he got to grow at his role. And it's not, and I push him every day. You know, I'd say stuff to him to just mess with him, you know, just, and so you just weren't going to go. You say you weren't going to shoot that shot. So you don't get to the basket and you made that pass. And, you know, I challenged him to become a guy that's 6'3", that played the point guard and been a great player at Tennessee Tech and transferred close back to home. He's from Homer, Louisiana, transferred home. You know, I challenged him, hey, man, it's your senior year, score the ball. This is what we need you to do. We need you to play, mate. We need you to score. Same way with Ivy. Hey, I believe he's one of the best point guards in the swag. I done watched film. I done did it. I done seen it all. I think he played with anybody in the swag. So, you know, we didn't get anybody on our conference team. But like I said, it's not about how you start. It's about how you finish. And it's about having the same building blocks that you begin with, that you end with. So the thing is, you're going to have hard work, you have discipline, you have accountability. And if we do that throughout the whole season and stay together, hey, we let the chips fall where they may.
Coach, we have a big non-conference schedule approaching. How do you kick the season off right?
Just tell these guys every day that if you make that play at VCU, we go down 20 real fast if you make that play. And, you know, I just try to tell them just about the plays that we want to make, how we want to play. How we want to be sure with the ball. You know, we want to be sure about passes. We don't want to just guesstimate a guy being there and it's a turnover. You know, and I'm big on ball protection. We got to protect the ball. Every day, you know, every game we walk into, we want to be less than 12 turnovers. You know, and that's going to go up and down. It's going to fluctuate a bit with the pace of the game. But we always want to be under 12 because being under the 12, that means you're taking care of the ball.
Coach, talk a little bit about that schedule. You know, you got VCU, you got Iowa on the schedule. You know, just talk a little bit about these road trips.
Well, we go start off at VCU, then we come home for a couple days. We go to Iowa, South Dakota. You know, we got South Dakota was really, really good last year. Iowa was good last year. VCU's good almost every year. So you walk into a game, and you know you got to come compete. You know, and like Coach Murray said before me, we didn't come to lose. We came to win. So, and I got to tell our guys, if you compete well and you do what you're supposed to do, then people can be in for the shock of their life. So we can control what we can control. We got to control our effort. We got to control our intensity. We got to control our focus. We got to control what we can control. And then from there, we can't control if we make shots, but we can control if we defend. We can control if we force tough twos. We can control that portion of it. We can control if we try to go fight and rebound. That don't always mean we're going to get the rebound, but you got to go fight and try to rebound. So we got to control what we can control.
Ivy and Shermaine, unfortunately no postseason this year. You know, just talk about that and how it sort of just shifts the mindset of the team a little bit and what you guys want to get out of this season.
Well, I don't think it changed mindset at all. We had the same mindset regardless if we're just going to be after swag, if we could have went to the NCAA. If not, we're still going to have a championship mindset.
Well, I think the guys are more focused on the non-conference schedule. We're looking at the non-conference schedule as our postseason, if that makes sense. Like we want to knock off a lot of them top teams and let all the other stuff take care of itself. But we can't control the postseason, so.
Ivy, you get a chance to go home and play in Washington. How big a game is that going to be for you?
It's going to be the same mindset that I have every other game. I'm not really worried about just going home. I'm worried about playing tougher teams rather than CIU. I'm not saying they're a bad team, but we're playing against VCU's. They've been to the tournament probably every other year, so VCU's been there probably every year. So I have the same mindset if I'm playing CIU or any other team.
Talk about a bit of the culture shift from being from Washington to, you know, being down here in Louisiana and playing ball and then just living and being here.
Well, it's very different. It's very different. The weather's changed a lot. It's been cold to hot, so as you can see, I'm kind of a little sick, congested, so I'm just kind of getting used to it. I like the culture out here, so I mean, everybody down here is very like family-like, and I really appreciate that, so I mean, I can't really complain anything about this place. I love it.
What was it about Grambling State that, you know, that sold you to come down here and be a part of this program?
Well, to be honest, I really didn't know much about Grambling when I came from prep school. So when I got offered and I did some research on Grambling, and all my family members told me about Grambling. All the older head people there, like, Grambling's a great place to be. And I didn't really understand, but when I got here, I understood what they were talking about. And I really, like, I appreciate what they told me because it means a lot, and I love this school.